श्रीमते रामानुजाय नमः। In the development of,
please switch off mobiles. No interruption.
Put in silent mode. In the course of development of multifarious disciplines, there are sub-disciplines. Now, recently, we have found out two major divisions in understanding the primordial unit of each and every faculty, number one, and number two, understanding the common substratum for all faculties. When knowledge blossomed, it started with the pursuit of a person's survival. A person's necessity to survival that has made the person, that is known as emergent engineering. In the ancient so-called anthropo-historical period, it started with the persons as per the history. It started with the need of a person to survive, and whenever he faced a problem or whenever it occurred with a difference of opinion or observation within his people or within himself, it has tempted the person's inquisitiveness to search for it and to create an acclimatization or accustomation process, which was the first invention of mankind. First, I want this fan. Now you know that each and everything is being dealt in different manners. Before few decades, the whole world consists of only three members. One is the forces, second are the ingredients, number three the living beings. First, the science is classified into the forces of our atmosphere, the surrounding, the ingredient of our base and substratum. The third thing is, irrespective of their spatial standards, the living beings, their quantitative and qualitative study. This has resulted in the primary science. What is the primary science? It deals with physics, which deals with the forces of nature, chemistry that dealt with the ingredients of nature, and biology that dealt with the species of nature. This is the primary science. Before so many decades, you may be knowing only about these sciences. And later, lot of studies about even when the human beings, they at the time of innovation of various things, they have forgotten their way of life. It is just like a mortgage or an adverse effect. At the time of growth, the so-called technical and scientific growth, they have forgotten the way of life, to lead a life. Just as it has been told by the famous creative thinker and novelist Victor. He told, before we have been teaching human beings how to behave with humans. Now he has been so made deplorable that we have to teach how to behave with nature, animals and plants. So when the human beings, all-round development is not there because of an unplanned or avarice or emotion tempted attraction towards a particular unilateral phenomenon without minding, the unanimous development of his wholesome structure, which is nothing but a constitution with constituents of mental precision, intellectual precision, and the so-called spiritual nourishment and precision and stabilization, along with a physical sturdity, and also having a social and collective behavior, and also a behavior with altruism, also a behavior with a high-end, great emotional instincts like magnanimity, and high-end spiritual instincts like clairvoyance, perspicacity, etc. All of these various components, they give a compound definition for a human being. The more this side of materialistic dimension and development that they occurred at the cost of sacrificing or eroding or debilitating the person's innate infinite structure of his potential values. Now those things are reading different things. Now you know that they are interested in studying about the depth of each and every subject. That is the philosophy of the subject. You know that philosophy that deals with one epistemology of each and every subject, the metaphysical portion of each and every subject, and theory or technology of value construction. These three things, they basically form the philosophy. It deals with various things like teleology, what is the purpose of the subject, and chronology, what is the area from where it has been started and what is the chronological history. Then futuristics, where it is going to take us and what are the impending dangers or the adverse effects which we are going to see in the context of development. So this science is known as philosophy of science. And second, now we are seeing a common science which could accelerate all sciences, bind all sciences in a common platform, that these are all the modifications of the same element known as medha or wisdom. Here, you know that the atomic weight configuration and valency structures of the arrangement of various atoms, they result in the formation of different elements. Likewise, the configuration variation of the same thing, the same faculty or a common faculty of wisdom. Wisdom is a quality by which anything that is desired, that is known as inquisitive, that which is required, that is known as necessitative, that which is very much sought, that is known as emergent, that which is going to serve a lot, that is known as fruitful or productive. So these types of something for a common purpose is known as productive, for his own necessity, necessitative, and emergent and inquisitive. These are all the various inquisitive instincts of a person's curiosity, which forms the base for science. I have already explained in the Young Science Conference that there are four basic instincts. They develop, they result in scientists. One is observation. Observation results in appreciation. Appreciation and possession is a common instinct. It is a dual instinct. We want to see something and we see the thing, we appreciate its qualities either by hearsay or by our experiences or the heard experiences from those who possess. This appreciation either leads to the dream to possess or to possess it at any stage of abstinency. So these basic instincts of just possessing things or appreciating the possessable things, that is a common instinct. When it develops into making a same thing by our own effort, that becomes creative instinct, and to make a thing that is better than that is known as an innovative instinct. These two instincts that is there in the development of the epistemological survey, anthropological survey of mankind, that has resulted in the formation of sciences. I told modern branches, two branches for all faculties commonly. One is the philosophy. I have already told, philosophy is very common. Philosophy is not connected with anything that is paramaterial or transcendental. It is a type of philosophy. As Sophia, the knowledge of the divine only is considered to be the worthy knowledge by the ancestors, the philosophy term, directly it was attributed to the philosophy of impalpability. Later on, now we have understood the thirst of knowing, the foundation and the fundamentals of foundation, components of foundation, the theory of its evolution, its multiplicity, its varieties of presentation, their development and their synchronization, their application by utilizing the spirits or components of your intelligence known as grahana, dharana, milana, sankalana, pravachana, prayoga. Attention, absorption or assimilation, retention, collection, recollection and application. These are all the skills of the component elements of the so-called intelligence. Apart from this philosophy, which is there in all sciences, you can do MPhil in all sciences, you know that. Now there is a new emerging science known as ontology. What does this ontology deal about? That which is not even filtered, that which is, you are having lot of elements now in discovery. Now the microscopic creatures that are more than to the power of minus 100-200 microns, they cannot be seen by a mere clinical microscope. So advanced level of telescope, spectroscopy and microscope, everything is invented. So whatever the things, they cannot be detected, they cannot be divulged through the study of philosophy, those things are understood in ontology. Ontology is a study of understanding the obscurities, reconciliation of the ambiguities, revelation and unveiling the portraits of the greatness of abstruseness is the work of ontology. Now the persons are in such a position for professional understanding, for earning money and life settlement, it may not be required. Mere application, mechanic which everybody does like a robo or cyborg. If a person imitates just for his payment, prosperity, development, transfer and promotions, which are all the visible benefits of knowledge and limited benefits of knowledge, anybody can do it with their master degrees or some doctorates. But ontology is meant for jnana pipasus, the persons who are willing to govern the world. There are two things. If you want self-maintenance, you can read the faculty. If you want global governance and maintenance, you have to deal with ontology. That if you want to cook for you, a small vessel is enough. If you want to organize a marriage festival, then the area required, the materials required, the vessel sizes, the ingredients included, everything will be more. It depends upon whom you are going to apply. It cannot be, we cannot bring all people to the same platform. That is the wonderful blunder of modern education system, which has resulted in successful failure. The thing is, how can you group the person's ability? How can you group person's career position? How can you group a person's intelligence and intention? How can you group? Like a sheep, there is a flock of sheep which will be driven by that is shepherds. They will have the same work. They will have a monotonous pattern of moving and grazing and coming back. Either it's grazing or repatriation and self-flocking systems, they are all trained and tamed. And now we are put into such a flock which Jesus himself cannot make shepherdship in a very successful manner. Because number one, a person's career molding, a person's intelligence and ability design, and three, track analysis and proper channelization. These three things are very essential at the level of their 8th, 10th and 12th standard respectively, which is not being done by any person at all. So ontology is required only for people, those who want to contribute something to the pride of our nation. I have already told in that scientist conference, scientists are very visible in proportion. That two young scientists, that two Indian scientists, that two Indian young scientists. So if you want to bring pride, when I attended the seminar for concrete, nano concrete and nano cement, it is the process is going on in South Decatur University, international scholars they came. I told that it is a process up to 2011. We must build such a team which must tirelessly work for achieving it in 2009 or 10, being a pioneer of that concrete industries, that is leadership in the world. Likewise, anybody who wants to achieve. So I must certainly design everything, a product. What are all the synergy, energy and allergy factors? A real person, a real marketing person, his position is to not only describe the greatness, but also to reveal the weakness of the persons, whether it is affordable, accessible and productive to the person or not. So as a person to market this divine intelligence or the process of applied or collective consciousness, it is my duty describe for whom it is applicable and what must be the motto of life of persons, the purpose of life. I have already told teleology. What must be the purpose of life of the person who wants to come inside it? What is the connection between a weaver and a monkey? The monkey will totally spoil the weaver's process. Likewise, it may be non-related, it may be totally adverse, it may be beyond the reach, but if there is desire, if there is desire and if there is passion, divinity and destiny, it can be brought into control. Four D's are there. Desire and dedication, if the first two D's are offered, then the other two D's we can bring into existence. So let me start with the mind. You know that when the human beings were realizing about themselves and others, they first understood only about the surroundings. They were very much interested in understanding about the surroundings. Even now, human being, even if they commit some mistakes and if somebody quarrels with them, they will more concern about the person's quarrelsome nature and report about that without concerning their own mistake. It is a natural phenomenon. So, Pashyati Pareshu Doshan Ityuktam Subhashita Nivi Granthe. Like that, it is the nature of human being. What is the nature of human being? It is known as the observational instinct. It is not the self-introspective or analytical instinct. It is, there is two analytical instinct systems. One is endo-analytical, second is exo-analytical. This endo-analytical system that deals with a person's deserving nature, what are all the steps to be taken and how to work hard, these are all the endo-analytical procedures. Exo-analytical, he is doing that, I am also going to do that. Whether we deserve or not, whether the competition is viable or not, these things are not taken. Because it is the inherent blunder. There are 27 inherent blunders of human consciousness and behavior. Those things have to be eradicated by of self-taming or taming by elite, enlightened or ephemeral personalities. such personalities, they have to, it is known as, first thing known as confluential erection, second thing is known as influential correction. If it is done by the inner self or it is made by any external force acting on us, that is how it is made. Likewise, the human being's instinct just started with knowing about the surroundings and patterning the surroundings as per their taste, desire and necessity. Samjnanam prajnanam vijnanam. The knowledge about the self is known as samjnana. The knowledge about the surroundings made by the self is known as vijnana. The knowledge about the self on super self is known as prajnana. These are all the basic classifications made by the Vedic scriptures. Number one, just to start with, it was believed in earlier days in the systems of study, either in science or in philosophy, that mind is nothing but the function of brain. There is nothing known as mind, because we could see physically or in a gross procedure or process, we could not see any structure as mind and its functions. They consider that there is no mind at all, and mind is nothing but the image of brain. It was there in the primary philosophy. Even the great philosophers of the West, like Bertrand Russell, he told there is nothing known as consciousness. It is a specially arranged structure of the matter itself. And Charvaka, they told that Panchabhutadhi Chaitanyasya Jananiti. When these five elements are mixed, just as the betel leaves, the small calcium sediment along with the betel nuts, they are mixed. Some new red color which is not there already, it is a sandhi guna. It is a contribution of their unison. Like that, if materials are automatically mixed in a cosmic procedure, it creates consciousness. There is nothing known as consciousness. Consciousness is a specially arranged group of material molecules. That was the statement of Bertrand Russell. Likewise, the Charvaka philosophy, Bauddha philosophy, Jaina philosophy, then in Bauddha also, Vaibhashika, Sautrandika, Yogacara, Madhyamika philosophies, the Nayayika's contribution of consciousness, Pashupata, Sankhya contribution, the Yoga contribution, and that tenets of consciousness that exist in Vishishta Advaita, 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 Bhava Advaita, Shuddha Advaita, Achintya Veda, Veda. These things are subjected to philosophical discussions. Now, let me start with the study of mind and then the brain and then the consciousness. At first they told that there is nothing known as mind, and now they understood that brain was not absolutely independent for its functions. There are two types of actions. One is known as the inner life, second is known as the outer life. What we have as feelings, instincts, sensations and emotions. We do have appetite, we do have thirst and other things are the biological instincts. So these things, biophysical, biochemical, chemobiological, chemophysiological, biophysiological, biochemical, neurophysical, neurobiological, neurochemical, neuropsychiatric. All of these things are now read and everybody is training their brains now in the pursuit of what is happening, and they are very much confused about what is going to happen to them. Least bothering about the brain. So these sciences now, it proves that apart from the brain has areas. The areas that are classified by the Vedic Siddhanta as the areas of Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha. If it is olfactory, then it deals with the olfactory determination, acceptance, repulsion, olfactory identification, classification, elucidation, all of the things are in the olfactory sense. In the taste buds, likewise, determination, analytical study, permission, repulsion, all of these instincts are there, basic instincts are there. Then in the classification, these things are with lot of variations, inferential classification, cognitive classification with Esther memories, innovative classification of one's own standard of perception. Lot of these things are there, it requires a note to write all of these things. So we have these basic tanmatras, are behaviors of our five gross elements or organs and their functions, and the basis of which our physical activities, Karmendriya and Gyanendriya, they are bifurcated into two. And these Karmendriyas, they just govern the biological functions, and Gyanendriya, they deal with the biomechanical and biointellectual or biocognitive or neurocognitive functions. They have read that there are positions like carpus callosum, centromedial nucleus. These are all the major positions, like Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra. These are all the major positions, like hyperthalamus. These positions, they have understood that it is the aesthetic area. It is the area which deals with a person's psychotropic drugs or hypnotic drugs, or if a person is managing some sedatives, allergics, what is the area? If a person taste is there, if repulsion is there, what is the area? They have been subzoned into several divisions. How it is subzoned, I will describe you. If it is X, then XA. What is the function? What is the subfunction is XA. And what is the time destination and factorial determination for that XA is XA1. XA1 dash is for the subfunctions of the subfunctional subfunction. Likewise, it is well tabulated by Buddhi Mimamsa. So this everything they have understood, that brain has everything, but from where it receives everything and why there is repulsion in brain, why brain has no independent determination or decision in functionalizing something, by which it has raised a doubt that something behind and beyond the brain is working. And it may be a covalent creature, it may be an equivalent element, it may be even a hyper potential force which may be gross or even subtle in nature. That has resulted in understanding the mind, the image of brain. Where does the mind lie? We used to say that there are two etheric reticulums. One is exoetheric and endoetheric reticulum. Just as we see the Mahadakasha here, the space here, we do have a small akasha inside also, which is known as Dharakasha. And in yogic mystic study, see, you can learn about such things only in the specific sciences and specific grades. Can you read about Mendeleev's periodic table in biology? You cannot read about these things. And even can you read about differential calculus in second standard mathematics? Because that is variation of a specific subject, this is variation of specific grade. Likewise, if you want to read about anything, there is a specific science meant for that. You can get the answer only from that thing. You cannot answer one more science or one more level of science to answer a question is not a part of it or part of its accessibility. Likewise, mystical science deals with the understanding of endoetheric reticulum, by which the inner space consists of the repository of mind and its instinctive explosions. This mind, it consists of three major expansions: mind, intellect and chitta, determination. So this type of what we call buddhi or intellect, that is nothing but an expansion or extension of the same mind. Just as an infant is there, the same infant, by a biological evolution, he comes and reaches the stage of a youth. Likewise, the epistemological evolution on the basis of the natural manifestation system, number one, added with the circumstantial provocation. For example, naturally, if it is not developed for a person, that intellect, whatever the courses that you may teach and whatever the environmental or ergonomical conduciveness that to the person's value, it will not contribute. Even if a person is having the intellect, if he is in the rural area, if he is in the tribal area, if it is out of the reach of the school at all, he cannot do that. So intellect is an ever-existing, all-existing, all-encompassing, ubiquitous phenomenon available in all in equal proportions. Intelligence is available in equal proportions. What is intelligence and intellect? Intelligence is the crude capability stuff of a person to apprehend things, and intellect gives the proportion of his utility in the intelligence by which he has learned things. You follow the term? Intelligence is crude. This is intelligence. If I drink a few sips of water, that is intellect. Intelligence is crude. Intelligence is common with all. By the methodology of proper teaching, by the proper analytical study, synaptic pruning of his brain, there is synaptic connectivity in brain, just as we have in computers, the network and circuits used to have the neurons in the form of bits connected with synaptic connectivity. So, intelligence is common with all. In that intelligence, depending upon the degree of manifestation, since somebody it may be slow, because intelligence is governed by several reasons. One, if there is any problem in genetic orders, then he cannot have intelligent manifestation. It can either prevent, it can either delay, or it can even deny. It cannot be denied, but I used to say that. So it can deal with that. And a person's food habits, and a person's natural instincts like sleep, digestion, moving with people, his own self-relaxation, they also determine the person's nature of governing that intellect from intelligence. So, according to Shastra, everybody have equal opportunities and equal potency of retaining things and applying to things. The problem is their status from where they stand has not been analyzed by a psycho-intellectual analyst. And it has not been nurtured with the proper system of education, with a methodological, specified, customized instruction technology for that person, as they have been grouped with all. It has not been made reachable by all people. This is the reason. So this intelligence that becomes wisdom, then it gives an inbuilt potency. For example, if I say something, I want to do that. It is just a statement which expresses my will, which requires a lot of process to that thing to happen or to accomplish. And wisdom is a potential will. Wisdom is a potential will. The persons with the potential will, they are known as Siddha Purushas. For example, it is known as the process of stage evasion. Just as you have crisis management and risk reduction, there is stage evasion in the phenomena. What is stage evasion? If you want to access something, you think, you either do by yourself or delegate somebody to do that, and you possess the things. So between your desire and accomplishment, you have some interim stages wherein by you do something practically. So Siddha Purushas, they have such a potential will out of their transcendentality by which they can think, and immediately their thought fructifies into such a system of accomplishment. So these things are miracles. These things are coming under not psychology and parapsychology, but under eritology and thaumatology, the study of miraculous, unusual happenings of human brain and its functions. So here, these are the small, this subject is a dry subject, number one. Number two, this subject has no previous background of either experience or exposure or erudition with any of the persons. Person, those who have completed anything with cognitive sciences like neurosciences, neurobiology, and even psychology, philosophy, all of these sciences like artificial intelligence is very much connected with that. Quantum physics, persons who are connected with these things, certainly they can understand, and it is not a single test of false. And how to develop consciousness by our individual and spiritual mental practices and how to apply it in various fields, that I will finish within few minutes. Then, now we are having computer. Somebody asked me about the relation, difference and similarities with a computer. Human being's brain is more powerful than computer. Millions of times more powerful than computer. That is what you say, ayuta yutamshe. The whole bibliographic documentaries and documents that have been ever printed, reserved, destroyed or about to be written and proceduralized, everything can be kept inside the jnana akasha of a person within 0.0000 to the power of 21. So, such a vast space of accommodation and retention is there in human jnana. The wholesome production, reproduction, elucidation and creation of the history of either printed or written or documented or any type of works that have been done or being done or that are to be done, you can put 21 zeros, 21 decimal places you can make for that one. That 0.00021 zeros, one. Within that area you can just manifest. It is not for a great accomplished soul or a divine incarnate or a celestial descendant. It is not for that. It is even for a common person. So now in neurosciences, especially in a new science known as operational architectronics, they are just analyzing what is the area, the accommodability of the brain and how much it has been utilized, whether it has been utilized properly or not. When we saw a room, when we are going to stay there, the room was full of, damped with all things, and there was no other place also to keep. There were a lot of racks inside, and instead of making that a horizontal distribution, scatteredly keeping them, everything was vertically properly organized, and something like space management in construction, they used to say, something to keep under the cart and other things, then the room was spacious enough. See, enrolling knowledge inside your mind is entirely different from dumping information for examination or performance promotion. If you properly place things, it is known as Sushka Dhana Swarna Hiranyaya. If you just to purchase lot of woodlocks for 1 crore rupees, what will be the space required? Or if you purchase straw for 1 crore rupees, where will you do that? Even Rashtrapati Bhavan will not be sufficient. You convert everything into 100 rupees, then it may require a few rooms or one room even. If you convert it into gold, then 2 suitcases you can do that. If it is into diamond, you can keep it in your pocket and walk away. Now the people, they are overburdened with what they call knowledge or wisdom due to some emergency, not for long-term benefit. It results in their memory erosion and emotion erosion. Such people, either they are gifted with a bald head or spectacles. Or digestion, his abilities, insomnia, back pain, then headaches, like even great headaches, indescribable pain, incurable and undetectable. So there must be a proper procedure and proportion of your physical ability, one. Number two, your intellectual ability. It must be measured. There are measurements. Gadgil was saying that there is no measurement at all. There are two things, Vyashti and Samashti. Can you measure air? You cannot measure air. But the air, if it comes to your cycle tube, you can measure it. In Samashti, as a concept of universal phenomenon, we cannot measure anything. But you can measure everything if it comes to a limited or demarcated transient package. The measurement of your emotions, it is known as emotics. Your biological instincts like appetite, everything can be measured by bionics and biotics. Your happiness can be measured in eudaimonics. Your sorrow can be gauged in melancholics. Each and every instinct of you, either connective, relative, concrete, universal, global, personal, super personal, preternatural, interpersonal, all these instincts are having their own measurement, gauging and understanding, evaluation of one's own level, and evaluation of one's own level to be accessed, and the stages required, and the challenging forces that are available, everything can be read well. Very simply, it can be manufactured. So this type of, it is known as psychometry, geometry is there for this. Phonometry is for sound, like that. Psychometry, ontometry, epistemometry is a measurement for all things. If it assumes, if it gets inside, if it sojourns inside an ephemeral, transient, limited package, these things are measurable. So this type of intellect is very common, I've already told. There is a common instinct, emotional, higher level of emotional instinct, which can be diverted to anything. Whether it may be an equational study in chemistry, or derivation of physical forces and their abstracts in physics, or the evolution standards and classification, sectorial and taxonomical classification of living beings in biology, arithmetic and calculus and algorithms in supercomputational as well as algorithmic and arithmetic systems, or data processing, chronometry and chronodata reminiscences in the face of history. All these things are governed by a single act, that is known as Medha. Nobody in the Vedic system, they ask for knowledge or something else. They ask only for Medha. There are some suktas of Vachaspati. Ye trishapta pariyanti vishpa rupani vibhrataha Vachaspatir bhala tesham tanvo adya dadhatume. Ye trishapta pariyanti. What are all the 21 elements that are there around me? I must get the fundamental knowledge about those things. That too immediately, that too completely. Exhaustive knowledge of the basics of all elements, the ontology of all elements. The 5 elements are akasha. Then 5 dhanmatras. If it deals with, for example, Shabda Dhanmatra, how many sciences are there? Acoustics, aquaphonetics, phonoacoustics, phonology, phonetics, phonomorphology, monomorphology, polymorphology, linguistics, paralinguistics, multilingual study, comparative literature, literary consanguinity, syntax, semantics, lexicography, each and everything, thousands of sciences are there. Somebody asked me, Swamiji, we need not want anything from you, just to give your Ashirvadam. Then I told that it is just like asking, I don't want 100 rupees, give you a blank check. It is just ontology, getting the fundamentals. So practically, to begin with, let me say some simple words and finish this session. Number one, you must just decide your purpose, where you are going to serve. When I went to a grocery shop where we used to purchase some things, I have forgotten my list. And the person, as he is a regular supplier, he just asked who are the visitors and relatives. Then immediately he understood what they used to have very normally and he gave the ingredients. So based upon the quality and quality, he has already that is accessed and asked the persons. Likewise, first you take a paper and write what is your purpose, where you want to shine, where is the level of your satisfaction. If your level of satisfaction is mentioned, we can give the idea of the amount of intelligence that is required and also the channelizing process for that. Number one. Number two, there are a lot of things. One is known as phobia and second as mania. Without any deserving or without any planning, blind attraction towards something is known as mania. And a blind aversion towards any reason, it may be due to some reason, but that is not phobia, that is hallucination. Just imagine is different from hallucination. Hallucination is different from realization. If you just think that there may be somebody, that is imagination. If you see, or if you have a contra-imaging inside your mind that somebody is standing there, that is known as hallucination. Who is not there is misimaged inside your mind. Because your own assimilation or expectation of somebody, it creates a pseudo image in your inner mental screen. For example, somebody dead by suicide. You are thinking, totally thinking, not even you must have thought God like that. 24 hours you are thinking about the person. Then that continuous flow of thoughts being potentialized, that creates a vacuum projection of the person, which is known as the pseudo imagery projection. It is in the intra image processing system, which is a part of the psycho computerization. Just as you see image processing here. So you see a person who is not there. Others may say that he does not. But subtly you say that the person is there. That is hallucination. Really seeing a person who is not visible to all, but is seen by your development, that is known as realization. So seeing a person who does not exist is hallucination. Seeing a person who exists but not seen by everybody is known as realization. Realization is a spiritual development or spiritual strength. Hallucination is a mental weakness. And this type of, first of all, a person must be gauged. First, take a paper. Really, I am not joking. Take a paper. You write the list of colors you like. In the pathological systems of homeopathy, I think that we can make, instead of talking as a very tedious process, we can make a lot of syllabi in India International Multiversity. And that's what I told. You are going to create students, scholars and other people. We are going to create scientists. This process is meant for only people, those who are going to become just one in 1 lakh of the society. This education, which we are going to offer through the multiversity, is to create people who are one in 1 lakh. The strain that they are going to take is 10%, 1 by 10th of what they are taking for struggling with other things. So it is reduced in the strain, but it is induced with the effect. So in the Kant's Materia Medica of homeopathy and even in the Ayurveda Shastra, consider the person's mind before treating him. What is his allergy? What is his acceptance? What is his basic alluration? So everything is being properly tabulated and categorized, then the person is defined. It is going to come after 10 years. It is the customized regenerative medicine. For headache, the medicine will cost $20 million. First instant, then afterwards they may reduce if they concern. So likewise, each and everybody must be defined. First of all, you know, that's what they used to define in consciousness, that there are two consciousness. One is phenomenal consciousness and second is access consciousness. Being a thing is phenomenal consciousness. Being a thing, yes, I am, aham asmi, that is phenomenal consciousness. And being conscious of a thing is known as access consciousness. First is being, that is known as satta. Labdha satta, we used to say in Sanskrit. Satta is being a thing. If you are being a thing, that is consciousness. if you are being conscious of the thing, that is also access consciousness. That's what I am wondering. They used to say, Andhenaiva Niyamana Yasandaha. They read everything with their mind. They understand everything with their mind, but they don't know the mind. They grasp everything with the intellect, but they don't know the intellect. It is their consciousness that percolates in them to make them eminent scientists and technocrats, but they don't know about the technology and science of their consciousness. And God makes everything, and the made creatures, they don't realize God. So this is the wonderful pun of the world, in which the real basic element is not understood. And when it is understood, we can prevent three things. One, whatever that we do is limited, and that is not serving the mass, it's limitation. Number two, whatever that we invent now as something good, it becomes adverse. Number three, whatever we think that we are doing it, it becomes futile, it gives no result. Whenever the fundamentals are known, these three endangering hazards of making it futile or semi-fruitful or adverse, all of these things can be prevented. And the real prospective providential source of scientific shower and benevolence to the society can be bestowed indubitably. So the intelligence must be first governed with self-analysis, your own instincts. What are the problems you have? See, the person's intelligence is eroded with instincts. That is the difference between computer and human being. Number one, a computer has no emotion. Computer has no emotion at all. All of the data that has been fed inside is made for uninterrupted self-processing, except by mechanical errors or interruptive errors from other side through virus or something else. It is not having emotions at all. For example, shall I say a small thing? To read a lesson in, for example, computational logistics, you are reading one lesson. For that lesson, you are spending 10 units of your intellect. Gunika, 10 units you spend. Simultaneously, you are scolding at a person or being avaricious of something or jealous. That consumes 20 units. That type of erosion or reduction is not there in computer. Human being is a medley of various emotional, biological instincts. No doubt he is taking the intellectual journey as a goal of his life, either for a profession or for confession. He takes that. But the computer or any mechanical system, they are determined for that. That's why they used to say workaholic. Those who are having a mechanical approach of work, they used to say such similes to people. Yantra manushya. So because they are very much dedicated to that, there are two problems. Total dedication to this type of insentient ergonomical conditions, that also erodes your human instincts. And diverting your instincts towards the mean instincts, such as avarice, jealousy, etc., they are mean instincts. So there are two processes for that. Kindly note down. One is repension, second is rectification. Third is reduction. Possible, you can reduce it. So first of all, repension, swadosha jnapana, they used to say, daily if a person, and if you must have a research lab, experimental lab, I already mentioned yesterday, if a person reads Vedas, more prana is imbibed, so that more prana is retained inside his baka, by which he lives for more years, if it is properly applied. Then I told them to have a phonometric lab, like that of the cognitive research lab. I went there and asked at Allahabad. They are having for all emotions. Separate research. Department of Cognitive Sciences, Janak Pandey is the director. And Bishpilani is having for consciousness management. And Maharishi Mahashyogi is having for transcendental meditation. The impact of meditation in human bodies and the mind vibrations are felt, recorded, then diversified into applications. Likewise, why can't the ETH make a lab, experimental lab, for understanding the computational functions of consciousness? It can be proved. So repension, reduction and rectification. First you repent, then try to reduce. And your utmost goal may be rectification. Because most of your intelligence is governed, controlled, eroded and debilitated by these cheap instincts, which is not where the computer. Number two, you are having a process of manifestation. Computer has no process of manifestation. If there is a small infant, it must grow to some age and it must be properly fed. Because that human beings' biological evolution is progressive and processive. You know that, no? It is processive. It takes steps. Likewise, just as you are feeding some GB or MB inside your disk or inside a chip, you cannot feed everything inside a human being, except it is possible by a preternatural transmittive element. A supernatural transmitter like the divine personality or somebody immediately transmitting by a neural image capacitor by which all the brain imprints are immediately transferred just as it exists between the machine interfaces. So human beings, you require a process of learning. You must be fed with morsels. You cannot be just dumped with barrels. You must be fed with morsels. Whereas computer, being mechanical in nature, and as that is processive and manifestative in nature, and it is non-manifestative and processive, it is immediately adaptable. So computer works more than that. This is right. And number third thing is, human beings, they require application. They require application, whereas they require uploading. Uploading is already designed message that is fed inside. That is like ready-made knowledge. It is ready-made knowledge marketing or market of knowledge feeding. Whereas whatever we have through books, they cannot be done like that. They are not just ready-made. They have to be analyzed and they have to be developed. And the final most thing is, human being's brain is having two energies, two major energies. The first energy is to identify and understand its own strength. To identify and understand its own strength. And number two, it is having such a creative intelligence of producing elements by analysis with nature and its components to produce such elements which are more potential in multiple proportions. So the first brain's energy is to understand its own nature and energy. See, for example, the person who has invented or possessed a bike cannot run faster than the bike. The person who has invented the plane, he cannot fly with the plane, he can fly in the plane. Likewise, the first energy is the self-assessing energy in which it assesses its energy and applies it. Second is creative energy by which it understands the greatness of the components that are already available in the nature and surroundings. They understand them and applies it with the, they composes. They just assembles those things. For example, if there is an aeroplane, it requires part, it requires mechanism, it requires a lot of things like avionics, like aerostatistics, dynamics. So shaping it, engineering, then positioning, then hazard management, risk management, safety and security, comfort factor, everything is read gradually. So this is known as creative energy from brain. So human being, they cannot do everything by their own, but at the same time they know how to deal with other agents which can do and how to cleverly apply them. Likewise, human beings are capable of dealing with inferior, superior, ultra and infra species of the world. They can deal with the god, even though he is just a macroscopic structure, unintelligible than him. By the rope of devotion, he can be binded. They can converse with the great personalities, rishis and celestials by means of their offerings, rituals, penance and austerity. They can converse with animals and birds by their eco-friendly nature and by their psychoanalytical approach, and also by the process of their taming and training with domestication process of animals. They can move with everything, adapting themselves to them or adapting them to their own nature. They can do that. They can have super eco-communication technology. If they properly apply it, they can be the friend of the universe, making everybody the friends of global culture and betterment. Likewise, a computer which has been made by a human being, it has an uninterrupted power because of its natural fed up messages which are processive but not requiring manifestation, which are there made by the processing of a human being itself. You see, who made the processing, who made the updating and uploading, etc., it is made by the human being. So what is the speciality of a computer? The speciality of a computer is the greatness of a person. What is known as memory, what is known as smriti. We have already dealt with the smriti in various contexts. Memory is an ornament of intellect. Memory itself is not intellect. Memory is an ornament. It must require understanding, rejoicing knowledge, and also the cognitive skill of memory, not short-term memory which you acquire before the day of examination and forget very wonderfully after the day of examination. That is a short-term memory. Nobody can produce. Even I have never produced after the day of examination, because that is a compulsion in which we don't have. We have our own attachment towards the fruit, not the action. For example, if you drink bitter medicine, Why you are drinking in spite of being bitter? Because your health is sweet for you. So, as health is sweet for you, even though the process or the channel is bitter, you take that. Likewise, you want the degree or graduation, you profession. Profession will give salary, then promotion, then richness and luxury. So, the ultimate end of a person to be happy, comfortable and self-propellant, for that an unavoidable step is their education. So, intolerable this must be. As a crucial surgery, it must be undergone by each and every people. So, this real taste by which we make it rejoiceable, that is also a portion of intellect. So, the link to know everything is curiosity, loving each and every word that you read, like your cinema songs and cricket datas, loving them, rejoiceable knowledge. Number two, keeping everything automatically in your mind, capable of instantaneous remembrance. These are all the parts of memory which are the parts of intellect. So, that is instantaneous imbibition, unfading retention, spontaneous reproduction and application is a skill of memory. These three components, they constitute the memory. So, memory is not only studying everything. Whenever you want, you must be able to reproduce it either in the same way or in a descriptive or even more ornamental way. Just merely repeating the same thing makes no difference. It must be as the contribution of your own caliber and acumen. So likewise, these things are there in memory, but not there in the long-term memory. So this instantaneous process is not available because of human beings, you know, that to just begin to crawl, then begin to walk, then to run and to ride. It takes the biological development itself, the physical functions, it takes some time. So missions, they don't take some time. You prepare something for 15 days. You feed it, to reproduce it, within a fraction of a second it can be done. So the memories which are available in the computer system, computer is nothing but the replica of a seer's brain. There must be something which is known as divitulya, that which is having a celestial equivalent, which is called as a celestial equivalent. Whatever we have read about the sages, that they had everything in their memory, just as it has been told by some sages about the ancient seers, that they have churned the ocean of knowledge by their tongues. Just as by Mandragiri and Vasuki, the Milky Ocean was churned, they have churned the knowledge, all disciplines of wisdom by their tongue, like Mandragiri. Likewise, those people, those who are having, these are the qualities of machine. Now, you see, gratitude is a quality of a human being. We cannot just deny it. But now the example is only our dog. Some domesticated animals, you see that they don't move away, they are very much affectionate to us. And ferocity and bravery is also with us. Now you see, for each and every example, no human being is quoted. Only animals and flowers or something like this. So whatever we have in computer, one, data acceptance. Second, data processing as per the command. Number three, data retention. Number four, data reproduction. Number five, by artificial intelligence, data analysis, categorization and suggestive principles. Everything, all these things totally, that was nothing but a parcel or fragment of the brain of the ancient seer. So now we have to see the seer, the great seers like Vasishtha, Vyasa, Bhrigu, Atri, Vatsa, Khanva. We have to see, we can see them in the non-living instantiate form, the form of supercomputers or mega computers. So now it is, so it is your quality, whatever you are having in the computer, your quality that has been well placed in an organized structure, and because of your unorganized structure, it cannot be placed inside you. And even though you need not, you see, there are three things. One is memory, and second is inference and analysis, and third thing is reference. I do not say that everything you must have by memory. You must not keep it in memory. What are all the laundry products that you have given for the past 3 months? Somebody says that I keep in memory everything. What do you have? I know all the grocery lists that I have purchased for the recent 6 months. Why do you love that memory? So there are something which are known as exhaustive memories. Just as you use it, just disperse it, number one. Number second is quintessential memory. You use it and understand the essence of it and keep the essence only with you. Number three, let the things be separate from you. Whenever you want, you can go and get that. That is referential memory, either from persons or from books. Number four, retention. Something you must not forget, like satya, tapas, bhakti, you must not forget in your life. Keep it permanently in your retentive memory. So, something from reference. something from retention, something by inference and analysis. Everything you must not be expecting that somebody will tell you. It is just like somebody asking, somebody gave 2 1 rupees and asked them to go and purchase brinjal and chili, for example. Then the fellow came and asked, which for brinjal and which for chili? These things are very silly. Lot of things are by our inference and analysis. So you classify, put a classification table, how much you can have from reference, how much you can have from your own self-analysis and inference, that is by assumption. How much you want it in retention, how much you have to exhaust, how much you can extract and hold. These 5 classifications you have to make in memory. You prepare somebody from here, you make everything very clear about your characteristic analysis. I am not talking about the socio characters or your personalized characters. Just your instincts of color, taste, then allergy and other things, etc. Along with the 5 areas where you can put these 5 elements, so that you cannot see everything you put inside the recycle bin. Whatever that is required, that is filtered, that is for application, you put it here. But immediately, they are just remembering, see, lot of cinemas are there. They are remembering it with Dirgha Smriti. And whatever there that is in the examination or interview, immediately as they step outside the threshold of the office or examination hall, they have to forget it. And everything that they have studied will look like an alien to them immediately. They will promise, I have never seen this book at all. Somebody, you please classify and send, on the basis of which we can make a constructive program. So there are different types of consciousness. What is consciousness, I want to say now. I have already told, consciousness is the basic energy. I have already told when I was discussing about these things to Dr. Bhatkar, the matter and energy, spirit and consciousness, space and time. They are known as the Dvandatrika. There are the 3 duels. Matter has energy, likewise the spirit has consciousness, and space and time, they are collateral. They are the members of the cosmic government. These 6 people, they rule the cosmos. Likewise, here the spirit has consciousness. Consciousness is known as Chaitanya. And this consciousness, just as there are in chemistry, you might have read about the destructive and fractional distillation of the main fossil elements, which will result in a lot of byproducts and residues. Likewise, consciousness is the Moola Vastu, or it is the inseparable, infinite Dharma Bhuta Jnana, or wisdom of the soul, the spirit's inseparable attribute, which in different areas. Likewise, if there is a small drop of Ganges, it is also known as Ganges. If you see the big Alaknanda or Bhagirathi, that is also Ganges. Quantitatively, they may be different, but qualitatively, they are from the same Ganges. Likewise, even a small thing that you remember as a memory, even though you do a small thing by your brain, which is an acumen, even though you do a small thing by your repetitive practice, which is a caliber, even though you do a small thing by the means of your acquaintance, a habit, do anything that is of your execution tools, that is dexterity, resulting in all these stages, they determine only parts and parcels of, they are the scintillations or fragments of a composite structure known as consciousness. Starting from, for example, 1 unit of consciousness makes you to see this and take this. It is a function, a dexterous function of handling something. I am taking this and looking. This is also the function of a consciousness. But that is a function of a trivial level of consciousness. Infinitesimal consciousness. Infinitesimal consciousness, negligible consciousness, proportional consciousness, analytical consciousness, considerable consciousness, paraconsciousness, super consciousness, applied consciousness, academic consciousness, depending on various areas, the names, the nomenclature has been made. And on different levels it has been made with the physical structure, clinical backgrounds or mental structures. For example, for an infant, what is the consciousness level? For an infant, the consciousness is unmanifested. For an ignorant person, the consciousness is unuploaded. Nobody has informed him or he has not approached the person. For a lunatic person, the consciousness network is disturbed. For a sleeping person, that is there in a state of drowsiness, that is in a state of stagnation, which is known as somnolence. Students of our normal socialized network of our society, the anti-socialized people, those who are isolated, those who are neglected, those who are abandoned, those who are considered as a tumor, rumor and night terror and mare for us. Such people, if they are properly nourished by a person who can have the capability of changing them without he being changed to their level. Such effective and hyper-capable persons must approach those people, and that is a misplaced. The vehemence that they have for achieving something and their tireless work till they achieve the goal, they are only following what Vivekananda has said. Don't worry, tirelessly you take your efforts and endeavor for something and don't get back till you get that. They are into that, they are least bother about anything to be lost. So they love sacrifices. So that is their greatness. So understanding the various members of the society, I have already told how the consciousness levels they have to be studied. By physical, number one, by clinical, number two, by their mental, number three, intellectual, two things are there. I have already told. Properly placed, super placed and misplaced. Properly placed is a track of a normal life with perfection. Super placed is for contributing the global welfare. Misplaced is for self-destruction or a collective mass destruction or genocide or whatever it may be. So, as this being the introductory lecture for consciousness, let us have a proper time. Bearing by, you must also develop a lot of questions inside you, and instead of just me saying something from the fundamentals, from the rudimentary schools of consciousness, dealing with a lot of abstract and dry philosophical concepts which have no color, glamour and valor, just as you have in history and other subjects like mass communication, then media entertainment. There are a lot of very enjoyable classes where we want to conduct the classes even in night times. So this thing is not like that. So first, what I want to say is, whatever I have told today, it has been recorded. Just go through it twice or thrice. It has clearly defined you consciousness, the definitions of consciousness, multiple reflections of consciousness, and how to make ourselves to be a good receptacle of to the level of consciousness which we deserve or desire as per our mission of life. This I have concluded today and hope to see you again with individualized, personalized, customized mission and project-oriented advices and channelizations for you, as we cannot generally give all things for all people. Depending upon your skill, being analytical in maths, etc., or athletical, artistic in nature, or atheistic in nature, aesthetic in nature, whatever it may be, either it is theistic towards God, or it is towards material, or it is towards science, or through arts, anything it may be, let it be your proper selection, wherein by the application of consciousness will surmount you in the paramount peak of never fading fame and also prosperity to all of those who are connected with you. Narayan, Narayan.
One question.
Yes.
The definition of knowledge and innocence in the context of consciousness. The definition of knowledge and innocence in the context of consciousness.
Knowledge. See, you are knowing about this thing. You are knowing about this thing. To know. It starts with to know. It starts with apprehension. The basic instinct is apprehension. To know this is of different types. To know that it is a glass of water, to know that this water is H2O, to know that the water is in Sanskrit known as Toya or Pani in Hindi. There are several levels of understanding. Each and everything is informed, that is formed inside. Whatever that you get, that this is water, whenever you see a similar structure, you will get it connected with the term water, or whenever you say the term water, you will get flashed the formation of a similar structure like this. So these things are known as informations. These informations, that they are scattered. For example, if you are moving here, you are seeing different entities. For example, this is a carpet and that is a threshold and that is a staircase and that is a road, that is a car. Are they connected? Everything is connected with you formally? Huh? Are they connected with you with any order? They are having only one order, known as function. If you want to go from this place to your house, you have to unavoidably step on this carpet, cross this threshold, get down the stairs, take up an auto, you have to go there. Otherwise, auto, carpet, other things, naturally, do they have any formal connection or orderly placement? They don't have. So these type of informations, even though they are different, they are known as collectible or collective informations. They are not known as collectible and collective informations. Whereas, if you want to read about water, you are studying about the types of water like the rain water, storage water, underground water, that H2O, how electrolysis of water is done, all of these things, whether they are orderly placed or not. Say yes or no.
Yes.
So when you move a lot of things functionally, even though they are connected with your function, phenomenally they are not united. They are not collectible or collective. Unless you yourself have some other very whimsical and quixotic desire to collect it. So whenever you say about a thing and read everything about that, for example, if it is a digital recorder about sound, sound recording, sound reproduction, then analog recording, digital recording, everything that has an order or not. So the collective, collectible, orderly informations put together on a different platform, an exclusive platform for a same specific objective known as knowledge. So knowledge is defined as the collectible, collective informations that are being put on a specific platform for a same specific object. Repeat it.
Yeah.
No, repeat it in Hindi or something. I want to know how much you understand.
The knowledge which is collected.
You just tell it as a story. Let it be even depictive.
The knowledge is defined as per what you have said now, is a collected information which can be collected on a particular platform.
Orderly collection. What is orderly collection? If it is water,
yeah,
then what is the chemical structure of water? What is the physical property of water? How water is produced? What are all the forces of water? How it can be applied? And water resource management, then rainwater harvesting. Starting from the ontological study of water, you can come up to rain harvesting system. And water scarcity and global water crisis of 2020. You can come to any level. Isn't it so? So, this orderly, ontological, analytical and systemic placement of essential, there are two definitions, essential and number two, it must be essential information. You must not think that, given information about water, my neighbor is having water inside the pot. Is it very essential? It must be essential. And second thing, it must be authenticated. You must not think trivial and useless, water is coming in the boy's nose like that. So, collectibility and collective presentation of essential and authentic informations on the same platform of a same and specific object or structure or element is known as knowledge. And knowledge has come from know, to know. What are the steps of knowledge? See, I am asking you to get down. Asking you to get up. What are the processes? You say that?
See, if I have to get up, then I have to see what I can do for getting up. That is.
That's what I am asking. What is that?
So I have to use.
It is a very wondrous brain. Answer. Yeah. What is that?
So I have to use my brain so that
You did not use brain, uses you.
Huh?
What are the physical?
Yeah.
Reflex, response, yes. Reply, and other things.
Yeah. So by order. Physical body that I should get and stand up.
First of all, you are giving ankle pressure. It is known as ankle pressure. Then ankle acceleration. Then you are doing liftment, a process of liftment. Then mass balancing. Then self structure replacement or reinstallation of your physical gravity. Then you are making placements of walk and coming here.